in this edition of Art Loft from the Miami International Science Fiction Film Festival. Alike.
Alike is about a mother who sells her daughter to a facility that the government is hosting. They clone brains and put them into these robots of the kids that are sold.
Parallel Man.
And so what we've done is we've gone back to the Manhattan Project during World War II. Instead of discovering the atomic bomb, this universe discovers skip technology so they can jump through the parallel universes.
From the Florida Keys, Baygrass Bluegrass Festival.
I was approached because I love this style of music and they wanted kind of a new thing, so the director of Almirante Community Entertainment approached me to do a bluegrass festival for them, so I decided to do it.
Paradise Paint Out.
Artists have taken on this style of painting where they basically find places they love to paint. Architecture, nature, landscapes, wildlife. They set up their easels and they spend however long it takes for them to capture that image.
And from Miami Beach, Philodendron.
So this exhibition focuses on a particular plant, as the title may indicate, Philodendron. Most people are familiar with this as a common house plant, but what most people don't take the time to ask themselves is, how did this plant go from the jungle in the Amazon to my living room?
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation and...
In the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kaylin James, and from Bailey Contemporary Arts in Pompano Beach, this is Art Loft. Hi, art lovers. This edition of Art Loft will highlight events that are coming up very soon. We'll touch down in Miami Beach and the Florida Keys, but first, in a galaxy far, far away, downtown Miami, brimming with elements yet unseen by mankind, premier film screenings. We'll witness an epic battle for total domination. Audience favorite award, best film, at the Miami International Science Fiction Film Festival, it's all in the realm of possibility. Here's a look at two standout productions from last year's festival. First, an introduction to the student-produced film, Alike, followed by a look at Future Dude Entertainment's Parallel Man.
Alike is about a mother who sells her daughter to a facility that the government is hosting. They clone brains and put them into these robots of the kids that are sold. With the robots, they think alike and react alike. They work together to fight in the war, and they also get a superpower along with the programming. Miss Manley is our coach, and she told me we got accepted in the Miami Film Festival with Inspired Minds, which is where Alike is produced from, and now I'm here. Inspired Minds is a program where kids come together and they make films along with our three coaches, Miss Manley, Mr. Steve, and Miss Grant. And we make films to show across the world to help students be a better person. First place for the film prodigy category. It's exciting because this is our first physical award that you can actually hold, and I get to keep it, so it's going on my shelf. I just told my mom and she's really excited and happy, so when I get home I'm gonna show it to her. And also Emily came along and she's one of the actresses in it, and and she's really excited too, and everyone's just really happy to have the award.
Future Dude is a transmedia company out of Minnesota. What we do is we make games, comics, animation, and live action film. Yeah, for comic books, we brought Brainstorm, which is kind of a natural disaster with a scientific element into it, and Parallel Man, which deals with parallel universes and the multiverse. Parallel Man's about the multiverse. And so what we've done is we've gone back to the Manhattan Project during World War II. Instead of discovering the atomic bomb, this universe discovers skip technology so they can jump through the parallel universe. We've got Nick Morgan, the super agent, who's jumping through this parallel universe, and he ends up teaming up with his alter ego from our universe, who happens to be an out-of-shape blogger, video gamer, and it's kind of a buddy story about how they, you know, defeat the enemy and save the world, or save the universe. Parallel Man, we did a full transmedia blitz on that, so right now it's a comic book that you can see and read. We're just wrapping up on the finished product for an animation piece, and then in April we'll actually be releasing a mobile app device game so you can play Parallel Man on your phone or iPad. One of the things that Jeffrey, again, the owner of the company, he's very good at art direction and directing and keeping people motivated and moving forward. With Parallel Man, he definitely had that big vision that you were talking about earlier, that he wanted that, you know, that the animator sat down with our comic artist so the art would be very similar and go back and forth. A little different because we're taking a two-dimensional character and actually doing a three-dimensional rendering. But it turns out it seems to keep the product more cohesive together. And then it's kind of got like a Tron-like flavor, but it's not really Tron. It's, you know, we definitely push the envelope a little bit more. I guess the only thing that I would like to add is, other than coming down to the Miami International Science Fiction Film Festival and getting our stuff, you can actually walk into your own comic book store and say, hey, I heard about Parallel Man or Brainstorm. Can I order those? They're able to go through Diamond's distribution catalog and pick them out there.
2016's Miami International Science Fiction Film Festival, or MICFI, is January 15th through 17th. For more details, visit MICFI.com. Up next on Art Loft.
Artists have taken on this style of painting where they basically find places they love to paint. Architecture, nature, landscapes, wildlife. They set up their easels, and they spend however long it takes for them to capture that image.
Next, we return to the island community of Isla Mirada in the Florida Keys, where we meet artists performing at the Baygrass Bluegrass Festival. Here, bluegrass music has the stage, the field, parking lot, or anywhere else you feel like playing a tune. So grab your instrument of choice and let's jam Appalachian style.
I was approached because I love this style of music and they wanted kind of a new thing. So the director of Isla Mirada Community Entertainment approached me to do a bluegrass festival for them. So I decided to do it. Appalachian roots music, you know, it's the music that was brought here by our ancestors and kind of developed in the United States because of everybody's different backgrounds, you know, and before we all had TVs and, you know, video games and cell phones. This is what people did. You know, people hung out and played music. So there's lots of people around the festival hanging out playing music as well.
We play what we like to call outlaw bluegrass. We change a few of the traditions of the genre and bend them the way we want to, you know, and it's slightly different. We try to keep our instrumentation and our vocal styles and everything traditional while veering away from tradition with our lyrics, you know. So the tradition is something to me to be respected, but not necessarily a roadmap. It's like a foundation that you can build upon. Yeah, I just hope it's people find it exciting, and you know, I think I try to write music that you would want to drive fast to. I mean, that's basically my goal when writing music, you know, and That's when I listen to music the most, is when I'm in my car. And so if someone finds it exciting, then I feel like I've done my job.
Yeah, we're more like blue music.
We came down here last year after playing a bluegrass cruise, and just kind of fell in love with the place. You know, it's just got a really nice vibe about it, and they seem to just really love their music down here. And so the guy who put on this festival here, Robbie, asked us on back, and we were happy to come on back down. So yeah, that's how we got introduced to it. I'm glad to be back.
Because we do mostly original material, you know, it's not really considered traditional, but I think that people that like old time and bluegrass and traditional music really seem to like our music as well. You know, it kind of crosses over because that's a lot of what we listen to.
It's a churchyard auction, a sight to see.
You know, it seems to be in a lot of these sort of smaller communities, you meet really nice people who are really eager to just like spend time with you, not just come to the show and listen to the songs, but actually get to hang out with people and talk with them. And I think that was what we really identified with the last time we were here, and it made us excited to come back.
A house of stone.
For information on this festival, log on to baygrassbluegrass.com or visit fla-keys.com for the ultimate guide to Florida Keys arts and culture. This year's festival will be held January 15th through the 17th. Up next on Art Loft.
So this exhibition focuses on a particular plant, as the title may indicate, a philodendron. Most people are familiar with this as a common house plant. But what most people don't take the time to ask themselves is, how did this plant go from the jungle in the Amazon to my living room?
Now, from fresh air to plain air. At the second run of the Paradise Paintout in Isla Morada, artists are invited to participate in 5 days of painting in plain air, meaning in the open air. After the artists complete their works, they're promptly delivered to the Wet Room Gallery, all hosted by Morada Way Arts and Cultural District. Let's take a look.
Plein air painting is based in the French impressionistic style of painting. And over the past many years, artists have taken on this style of painting where they basically find places they love to paint. Architecture, nature, landscapes, wildlife. They set up their easels and they spend however long it takes for them to capture that image. When we talk with people about Morada Way Arts and Cultural District's Paradise Paint Out, we explain to them that we've invited 25 artists from around the country to come to the Florida Keys and to paint from Isla Morada through Ocean Reef, Key Largo. These artists show through their work how they see our beautiful islands. Some are painting along the highway, some are painting in little nooks and crannies, and a lot of locals and visitors have been able to see their favorite artists from start to finish creating these masterpieces. When they are finished with a painting, they bring it to our wet room gallery in the art district, and they price their art, we hang it, we show it, and oftentimes we sell it. It's been an extraordinary week. Many, many collectors have come in, identified pieces of work that they'd like to purchase, or walked out the door with art in their hands.
I've loved coming down here to paint because the scenery is so inspiring. I mean, I can't help but fall in love with everything that I've looked at so far. So, subject matter wise, it's been harder to decide what not to paint. The upper piece over here is a piece that I actually did at a place called Robbie's. And Robbie's, I'm sure the locals are very familiar with, but all of the different little venues and tents and everything set up that the vendors have were just tailor-made for subject matter to paint. The painting over my right shoulder was one that I did staying at La Siesta Resort. And I went down to the beach one morning and looked back, and I felt like the bungalows there sort of were representative of old Florida and all of the palm trees and everything. So it sort of just like was something to grab my attention. Every time we go to a different spot, they each bring their own sort of challenges that we have to figure out how to put into paint.
And many of them, like I said, have not been here before. So when an artist walks in with a piece of art and we immediately identify it, whether it's a little abstract or not, our hearts are just filled with that appreciation of the Florida Keys, of this paradise. This is Maradaway's inaugural paradise paint out. It's the first plein air paint out that has taken place over a week-long period in the Florida Keys. We have big plans for 2016. Next year, this paint out will be juried. We will have a selection committee. The 25 artists have been gracious. They have been helpful and created extraordinary pieces of work. And I was surprised personally by how they really engaged in our community and with our community. We have people here who are asking for these artists by name.
The Keys has its own sort of flavor, and so being able to try to capture that, I think, is one of the things that I enjoyed most. There's a certain vibe here, that, you know, the laid back, the casualness of it all. It feels good.
This year, Paradise Paint Out is January 20th through the 24th. For event information, visit maradaway.org. And don't forget to share the cultural wealth. Tag ArtLoft SFL on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram while you take your photos in the plein air. Now on view at the Norton Museum of Art in West Palm Beach. The summer of 68, photographing the Black Panthers. And this place, Israel and the West Bank through photography's lens. Both exhibitions are on view through January 17, 2016. Now, off to Miami Beach. At the Wolfsonian Florida International University, we tour and discuss their exhibition, Philodendron, From Pan-Latin Exotic to American Modern. This survey of works sets out to chronicle the centuries-long migration of Pan-Latin plants into our gardens, commercial designs, and international arts culture.
So this exhibition focuses on a particular plant, as the title may indicate, philodendron. Most people are familiar with this as a common house plant, but what most people don't take the time to ask themselves is, how did this plant go from the jungle in the Amazon to my living room? And of course, to be reproduced all across textiles, fashion design, furniture design. It's such a common plant, but we often don't think about its history. So this exhibition aims to explore the social and cultural history of that plant. And it happens to be a history full of really fascinating stories and some pretty stunningly beautiful objects. By the 1930s and 40s, the philodendron and other tropical plants had really exploded onto the American design scene. The interest in the region in which those plants come from, in South America and the Caribbean, had really grown in recent years. Travel to the region, stars like Carmen Miranda were capturing the American imagination. And the plants from those regions, as a result, really became popularized as a way to kind of bring that exotic flavor into your own home. And the two objects behind me, which were both designed in the 1940s by Dorothy Draper, are two of my very favorite examples. Dorothy Draper was an American interior designer who was really the queen of her industry in the period. She was known for her over-the-top designs, full of bright, bustling patterns and decorative flourishes. She was known as draperizing the interiors that she worked with. So she created this credenza and the wallpaper behind it as part of her line Brazilians in the 1940s. She decorated the interior of a Brazilian hotel and then used that as the inspiration for this series of textiles and wallpapers that were available in stores across America, and they were a huge hit with consumers. So the experience of the exhibition really begins as soon as you walk through the front gates of the Wolfsonian. We have a special installation in our lobby put together by landscape architects Mauricio Del Valle and Veronica Schunk. And this installation kind of gives you a sense of that tropical jungle or rainforest where philodendron are found in nature. It really sets you up with this sort of little secret garden, and against the glittering backdrop of some of our permanent objects and architectural features, it gets visitors starting to think a little bit about the juxtaposition of the man-made world and the natural world. One of the contemporary pieces in the show is an expansive painting by the Haitian-American artist Edouard Duval-Carrier. Duval-Carrier is a local Miamian, but he's also really a world-renowned artist, and this is one of his sort of signature pieces. It's a large, imagined landscape that has this sort of glittering, mystical quality to it, and is full of tropical plants. It also features a rider on horseback who is rumored to be Duval-Carrier's grandfather, and he's brandishing a flaming sword that has all sorts of connotations with Haitian history and culture. One of my favorite contemporary works in the show is a mosaic by Michelle Okadoner. It's a sample of a much larger piece she did for a cancer center in New Jersey called Healing Plants. It featured several plants rumored to have healing properties, and this particular one is called Dutchman's Pipe, which is believed to aid in childbirth. Now, Michelle Okadoner purposefully chose to use a sort of Byzantine mosaic style for this piece, with these really glittering gold tiles. And that sort of helps us to elevate the plant to a sort of mystical place where we can really appreciate it on a new level. Something that I think we hope visitors will take away from this experience is understanding that nothing really is what it seems. Every little thing that we encounter, even if it's a typical houseplant, really has an entire legacy of how it got to where it is today. There's all sorts of detours and roadmaps and stories that are really fascinating and can tell us a lot about our history as a culture.
Philodendron will be on view at Wolfson-FIU through February 28, 2016. For more information, visit wolfsonian.org. Thanks so much for joining us this week. Let Art Loft inspire your creativity every day. Visit wpbt2.org/artloft to watch past episodes. And you can also get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at ArtLoftSFL. I'm Kaylin James, reminding you to stay creative. Bye. Let's do this, folks. Quiet on a sec. Quiet on a... You can, you know what, close that door. Yeah, you know you have to lift that thing up. Yeah. Oh, hey. You broke it. I'm just... Ooh, it's hot as Hades in here, Jesus. I see your butt crack. No, thank you. The Baygrass Bluegrass Festival. That's not right. Set of choice, and let's jam. Appalachian style. Ding 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 ding. Be like, what's wrong with your ears? Why are they bleeding? Oh, I was just working with Kaylin today. That's because I'm the Baygrass Bluegrass Queen. Hi, my name's Kaylin, and I'm the Bluegrass Baygrass. I'm the Baygrass Bluegrass Festival Queen 2016. Welcome. My talent was banjo. That was a mouthful. Mm-hmm. And on this festival, log on to... unless you get the miracle baby that sleeps through the night from the beginning. That first, what, 6 months to scare the cultural wealth. You didn't like it. Okay. Oh, thank God. Followed by a look, I've screwed all that up, but you said you liked the first one of those, right?
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation and...
In the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida.